I'm Tara from Ukraine and welcome to my channel again. And in today's video I have a guest, Valentina. Some of you might know that she has her own agency.
Yes, in Dnipro, Ukraine, International Romance, but we already stopped the work and I decided to focus on some nice videos for the guys which help to find true love. And it will not matter which agency will you choose or what city, but this advice will be good enough to find true love.
Yeah, today we would like to discuss and give you finally honest, true answers from person who knows about this business, who knows how to choose, how to do this, how to choose an agency and a girl. Because sometimes agency works for themselves, a girl for themselves, and everybody doesn't know what's on each other's mind, right? And yeah, they're like, it's not my business, yeah? And then you blame my agency or a girl. So the first step when a guy wants to find a love, what he should do?
I think that cheating never help. Even if it will be true girl and you speak a lot with her, but then you can come. I have a lot of story like that. Even me 5 years ago, I speak with a guy from Sweden, and we like each other very much in the internet. We spent a lot of time, even this video, in the Skype. And then when he came here, I realized that I don't like him at all. So it was wasting of time, and really I can do nothing with it, and he can do nothing with it. He is nice, but maybe some energy. So that's why I all the time say that you should come and meet personally, because it will be very different.
You were very disappointed. Like, did you tell him like truth? And he was also disappointed. What was his reaction like?
Oh, he has very bad reaction.
Yeah.
It really say, yeah, I did video for the girls and tell that it's not right to meet guys from internet, because it can be such a different people which come here and you never know what is in his mind. So about agencies a little bit, it's a lot of different agencies. They try to do the best. Some of them I think very, very nice, some just scammers. But in Dnipro City, I didn't meet very nice agencies before, because all of them do paint letters. And I think if you go to the website and you need to pay for letters, that means that it's fake. Of course, you can communicate. Maybe it's nice to pay, or you know, the agency should get some money. But the reasons why it's fake, because this photo is such a difference. I tried to work with some agencies. It's very bad, because they don't know girls. They can meet them only once in photo session, and this photo session is so fake. When you go to a date, she is so different that you think,
yes,
oh my god, who is she? And you don't know what to say to your client.
A lot of men who write me, for example, Taya, is it true about these girls, because all of them look so beautiful and Photoshop? And for example, in my agency I have real more or less real photos, but I have only like a little bit of girls, and they are like, I don't believe yours, because there's more girls who are more beautiful and Photoshop. I'm like, okay, it's your choice, guys. But really, it's a first sign of a scam. If you need to pay for message, and if there are a lot of thousands of girls, and usually, as I understand, agencies forget about those profiles. They don't delete if she's single or not single.
Yes.
They just put it as a number, so they can brag how many nice girls they have, right?
Right, and sometimes you go to some website and they have like minimum 800 girls, and for me it's, I have all the time like 150 maximum, because some girls come, some girls go, come, go, all the time everything change.
And you have to know, keep about everyone in mind, right? So you work with them, or your assistant, I don't know. Like,
we just do like psychology classes, because psychology classes help a lot. People start to speak very open. If you just try to speak with her with a coffee, she can tell some little part of her life. But when you start to speak very, very open, it's so different. And girls, and even girls, they start to believe you more, because each girl get to know you more and more, and we go out together. You know, it's very nice when you know each girl. because sometimes girl come to agency, I looks like she's nice, looks like she's looking for a man. She say, oh, I'm so
serious,
nice.
Yeah.
But in reality, she's commerce. We cage like 5 scammers in our agency. For me, it was funny because they try to get like $100 from and something like this.
From your agency?
Yeah, yeah.
They ask you for money, like
no. They for example go to a date and then ask for a taxi, $100.
Uh-huh.
But it costs $2 only.
Yeah,
and then
yeah,
guy
yeah.
come to me taxi. And tell me this. I think no way she can do it. She is very nice girl. Then I start to speak with her and
okay.
And I want to give advice, you should find men who want to come to Ukraine need to find nice personal assistant, nice matchmaker who will take care about him a lot. You can go to different agency, you can give to your matchmaker some website and she will check is it agency is real or maybe even if you need to pay for a date, for example, if Taya will be a matchmaker and she will go to the agency and she need to pay to meet this girl, but it's better to pay and to get to know a girl before you come.
Averagely, how much time do people need to understand it's their person and they're suitable for each other?
It's of course depends on personality, but I think that you need to stay with her a few days here, just go out, spend some time, and then if she really like men, she will go with him. Then ask her to go out from the city, for example, to mm-hmm, some lake, mm-hmm. and stay with her for a while. Because when men come here, he is in a vacation, he has a lot of time, and she is working,
yeah.
so he needs to wait for her weekend and spend 2-3 days together to get to know her more. After this, he can decide. But for sure, if he will come, he need to spend maybe 10 days with a meeting different girls. And after he choose girl, he need to stay maybe 1-2 weeks more to get to know her. Because if he just after some dates go home and start to chat with her, it can work. I have experience, my friend, he speak with a girl 6 months, come here, but he meet her before, come mm-hmm. here and in 2 days they broke up. It was wasting of time,
mm-hmm.
but I'm happy he find very nice,
yeah?
very
okay.
nice girl, yeah, they
know.
Started the documents now, but I feel sad that he waste time.
Yeah,
six
it happened. I mean, it's better to waste maybe a little bit time than a few years and take her to America. Let's maybe talk a bit of the next step of relationships, about marriage and all these documents. How, what, usually Ukrainian girls, they are ready to marry, like, how many years after dating? I know it's a very personal thing, like, and depends on age too.
It's very personal, but truly say, girls, if she like, if she fall in love, she can go married next day, truly says it's right, because mm-hmm. she understands it, a lot of documents. First, of course, after she meet his country, she can decide, I think like this. But some girls never go to his country, just go married and then go and they are happy. I have story which is from another agency. My friend has agency from Dnipro, she already worked 7 years. So she has like a lot of stories.
Mm-hmm.
And interesting that a lot of men don't want to go married. They have a date with Ukrainian woman for 4 years. And for me, it's like so strange that woman is like it.
I like it?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought she doesn't.
Well, if she doesn't, she will broke up with him, you know, she will do
exactly.
something here.
Mm-hmm.
But she still stay with him 5 years.
Interesting. Because it's not a typical for our Ukrainian girls. As far as I know, like, let's say roughly, foreigners can date like 5-10 years together, live together, have kids together, but nothing to do about official. But here it's very important to marriage officially after, let's say, 2 or 3 years, because then we have even the proverb, if you don't propose to a girl, then mm-hmm. she'll just understand that you are not serious and she'll say goodbye to
yes,
you.
Yes, and what is the difference between Ukrainian men and some Western men? That Western men come here and they are ready to go married and they are ready to have family. And Ukrainian men, because they have a lot of choices, I don't know, because some tension now in Ukraine, they just want to live together like a family, but it's not real family for Ukrainian men. And that's why Ukrainian women afraid is that if men don't ask you to go married for 1 year, it will be the same like with the Ukrainian man, and she started to seem bad.
Thank you a lot for advice. I think you understood how you should do when you only on the first steps on finding Ukrainian girl. I wish you the best, of course. Thank you for the interview and see you in the next video. If you have any questions, let us know and we'll try to maybe next time make another video for this.
Yes. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.